Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Betty, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. I now invite you all to be seated, and I invite Lucy and Eliza to come up to proclaim our readings.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. On this mount, the Lord of hosts will provide for all peoples. On this mountain, he will destroy the veil that veils all peoples, the web that is woven over all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord God will wipe away the tears from all the faces. The reproach of his people he will remove. For the whole earth, for the Lord has spoken. On that day it will be said, "Behold our God to whom we look to save us. This is the Lord for whom we looked. Let us rejoice and be glad that he has saved us." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The Lord is my light and my salvation. The Lord is my light and my salvation. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom should I fear? The Lord is my life's refuge. Of whom should I be afraid? The Lord is my light and my salvation. One thing I ask of the Lord, this I seek, to dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, that I may gaze on the loveliness of the Lord and contemplate his temple. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Hear, O Lord, the sound of my call. Have pity on me and answer me. Your presence, O Lord, I seek. Hide not your face from me. The Lord is my light and my salvation. I believe that I shall see the bounty of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait for the Lord with courage. Be stout-hearted and wait for the Lord. The Lord is my light and my salvation.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We do not want you to be unaware, brothers and sisters, about those who have fallen asleep, so that you may not grieve like the rest who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose, so too will God, through Jesus, bring with him those who have fallen asleep. Indeed, we tell you this on the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will surely not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself, with a word of command, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, will come down from heaven, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. Thus, we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, console one another with these words, the word of the Lord.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Alleluia. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, so that everyone who believes in him might have eternal life. Alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. I'm going to try to hold it together during this homily. I really adored and loved Betty so much, just like all of you here. Dear Marlis and John, Roger and Susan, Steve and Charlotte, Mike and Shelley, all your beautiful children, and all the family and friends of Betty Marolt, on behalf of the St. Mary Parish community here in Aspen, I want to sincerely welcome you all to this massive resurrection for our beloved Betty. Whenever I prepare my mind to minister a funeral mass, it gives me peace and consolation to contemplate why we gather here for this. We are here to give praise and thanks to God for Christ's victory over sin and death. We are here to commend Betty to God's tender mercy and compassion, to give Betty a proper and dignified Christian burial, and to find strength in the proclamation of eternal life through the resurrection of Jesus Christ. It is truly my honor and privilege to be the celebrant of this funeral mass for your beloved mother, grandmother, and friend. And from the depths of my heart, I offer you all my sincerest condolences on your loss. Please know that Betty and your whole family will always be in my prayers and have a very special place in my heart. It was so touching for me to read the wonderful column that Roger wrote in the paper about Betty after she passed. What a beautiful, exciting, and faith-filled life Betty lived with her husband Max and her children here in Aspen. Steve, Mike, and Roger have told me many other great stories about their mother these past 4 years I've been here. But I'm not going to delve into stories of her amazing life. Betty's daughter, Marlis, will come up here at the end of the liturgy to speak some words of remembrance that I'm sure will be very touching, and I'm looking forward to hearing. the scripture readings chosen by the family here for Betty's funeral embody a powerful theme of hope. The first reading from Isaiah reveals to us that on the mountain of the Lord, a great heavenly banquet awaits us. And the prophet tells us that here is the Lord for whom we looked. Let us rejoice and be glad that he has saved us. And the words we heard from St. Paul in the second reading bears repeating. He says, for if we believe that Jesus died and rose, so too will God, through Jesus, bring with him those who have fallen asleep. I think this passage is one of the greatest messages of hope in the entire Bible. St. Paul assures us that our death here on earth is not the end. It is only the beginning to eternal life. And finally, in the gospel reading, we heard the beginning of Jesus' Sermon on the Mount. In this portion, he gives us the Beatitudes, which is one of the most familiar gospel passages. And like so many scripture passages, we can look at them from different angles and see different meanings and importance. In this powerful sermon from the gospel, Jesus teaches us that God does not make our human struggles. Instead, God enters into them with us. God does not promise that we will not suffer, but that we will be blessed in those tears. We will be carried and accompanied in our grief, and we will be consoled. As Jesus says in this gospel, blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. St. Augustine, he's one of the greatest theologians of the Christian faith. He once said this about the Beatitudes: the pursuit of God is the desire of beatitude. The attainment of God is beatitude. We pursue him by loving him. We attain to him, not indeed by becoming what he is, but by becoming close to him, as it were, in some marvelous intellectual fashion, wholly illumined and wholly embraced by his holiness. For he is light itself. And by that light, we are permitted to be enlightened. all these inspiring messages from sacred scripture reveal to us a powerful truth, my friends, that death does not have the last word. Life does. Much of the secular world thinks that the story of human life is just birth, life, and death. But for Christians, it's different. The story is not birth, life, and death, but rather life, death, and resurrection. In the face of death, the church provides us in our loss and grief with a proclamation of hope. We are created for eternal life, and everyone who is baptized shares in the death and resurrection of Jesus. In his letter to the Romans, St. Paul teaches us that when we were baptized in Christ Jesus, we were baptized into his death. In other words, when we were baptized, we went into the tomb with him and joined him in death, so that as Christ was raised from the dead by the Father's glory, we too might live a new life. If in union with Christ we have imitated his death, we shall also imitate him in his resurrection, St. Paul says. My mother finally found a place better than Aspen. That's how Roger most eloquently titled his column. Yes. Heaven is a place of immeasurable joy that we can't even imagine here on earth. It's a place we are all created to be free. And we pray today that Betty has made her way to that beatific vision. And enjoying the best Manhattan, her favorite drink, with her beloved husband Max once again. So Betty, we need her up there. In between your bike tours of heaven, please say some prayers for us as we journey to join you there someday. Amen. Now, my friends, I invite you to stand. And I invite Max to come forward to offer up our prayers of the faithful. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church, confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus. We join our prayers to his.
Our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. In baptism, Betty received the light of Christ. May God scatter the darkness now and lead her over the waters of death. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Our sister Betty was nourished at the table of the Savior. May Jesus welcome her into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all our dear relatives and friends who have passed away and await the kingdom, may God grant them an everlasting home with his Son and all the saints. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the people in the world who suffer physically, spiritually, or emotionally, may Jesus bring them comfort and assure them of his love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the family and friends of Betty who seek comfort and consolation, may God heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered here in faith and confidence to pray for our sister Betty, may God strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your Son's coming. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer, Jesus Christ, and the voices of your people whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. I now invite you all to be seated. And the grandchildren of the family who are bringing up the gifts, you may go back now and bring them forward.
Please join us in singing our offertory hymn, Here I Am, Lord, in the Green Journey Songs hymnal, number 818.
And sky, I have heard bell in dark and sin. My hand made the stars of night. Who will bear my light to them? It is in heart you calling in, I will go, Lord. I will hold my heart. I, the Lord of snow and people's pain, I have wept for a way. I will break their hearts of stone, give them hearts for love alone. I will speak my life to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go. If you lead me, I will hold your people in my heart.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Betty, we beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life has changed, not ended, and when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy Lord, God of hosts, heavy Hosanna in the highest, the name of the Lord, Hosanna highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Savior of the world, for you have set us free.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, Samuel, our Bishop, and Jorge, his auxiliary bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Betty, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, to of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not in our sins, but in the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always." Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Blow away the sins of your wars, Lamb of God, you take away mercy on us. Blow away the sins of the worries, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Dear friends, for all Catholics present who have already received your first communion, you are welcome to come forward to receive our Lord Jesus in the Eucharist. We start with the side aisles, walk to the back of the church, come down the center aisle, followed by the center section. So side aisles, you may come around now. Thank you.
Let perpetual light shine upon her, for you are merciful. Eternal rest grant unto her, and let perpetual light shine on her, with your saints forever are merciful. One bread, Lord of all, one cup of blessing which we and we, though many, throughout the body in this one Lord. Servant or free, woman or man, no more. One breath.
all. One cup of blessing which we bless, and we, the many, throughout the earth, we are one body in this one, Lord. Many the gifts, many the works, one in the Lord of all. One Lord of all, one cup of blessing which we bless, and we, the many, throughout the earth, we are one body in this world. Make me a channel of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me bring your love. Where there is injury, your pardon, Lord. And where there's doubt, true faith in you. Make me a channel of your peace. Where there's despair in life, let me bring hope. Where there is darkness, only light. And where there's sadness, ever joy. O Master, grant that I may never seek so much to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love with all my soul. Make me a channel of your peace. It is in pardoning that we are pardoned, in giving of ourselves that we receive, and in dying that we're born to eternal life.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our sister Betty may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. At this time, my friends, I invite Marlis to come forward to offer words of remembrance, and you all may be seated.
So I have been working for the last 2 weeks to do this this eulogy, and it has been so difficult. I finally told my brothers a couple days ago that I was going to have to punt on it. But when I got here, I was moved to tell you just how she left. It's nothing short of miraculous. And I want to preface this. This is a therapist coming out of me, that in the Eastern traditions, they call all of us being in the bardo of death. And what that means is that ego gets confounded by the concept of death because it can't understand the magnitude and the finality of it. So ego goes offline, and we become more receptive to the more subtle dimensions, so to speak, that we live in. So when John and I were in Hawaii, when we got the call from hospice that mom was leaving. So it was about 10:30 Hawaii time, 1:30 here. So I called my brothers, and they all came to the house. And my mom's blood pressure was like 60 over 30, and she was on her way out. So they got to the house, and I was shaking so hard in Hawaii that I did what I always do to just calm myself. I went and did laundry. So I'm at the Mauna Kea doing laundry under the stars, and I got this impulse to call the house and see how mom was doing. And Lori answered the phone, and my mom woke up. And it was amazing because her dementia had gotten to the point where she had like a minute or two recall. That was it. She was really struggling. But when I called her, there was no dementia, nothing. And she was so present and so clear and recalled everything, that it was like being with mom 40 years ago. And she was so full of love, just beaming light and love. I can't explain it, but there was a quality. It was like she had started going across and came back to give us all the beautiful closure. So I got to tell my mom just how much I love her, how grateful I am that she is my mom, and just so grateful for all that she gave to me and made me who I am. So anyways, then she drifted off, and I got the call the next morning that she had died. So during the night, John was trying to make reservations for us to get back, and we couldn't get a one-way ticket. And so it took us forever. So we got back the following day. And we drove straight up to have dinner at my mom's house with my brothers. So after dinner, I wandered upstairs and I just sat on the bed where she died. And I put my hand on her pillow and I got this super hard flash of what life was like for her before she left. And I instantly said, Mom, I would not have asked you to stay one more second, because the contrast was so, it was like she had brought that divinity back with her when she came back, that taste of heaven when she came back. So that night when we finally got home, I was so tired and just spun out. And it was about 1:30 and I was sitting, you know, trying to get ready to go to bed. And all of this, I kind of drifted off into this meditative state. And my mom came to me, you guys. She was brilliant light and love. It was the most profound thing I've ever experienced. And then my dad came in and they were together. And he was brilliant light and love. And she had grieved him since the day he died. So it was like this full circle closure in every direction. And it's just representative of the life she lived. She just had this undercurrent of deep love and compassion and self-giving. And she was rewarded at the end. And I'm so grateful to have a mom that gave us such beautiful closure. So anyways, and that ties in with what Father's saying with the beauty of the resurrection and hope and everything else. And right now I don't feel tears of sadness. It's tears of such deep, intense love. And and I wanted to share this with you guys so that you could know. So thank you. And in ending, I want to thank all the girls from Aspen Compassion. We couldn't have done it without you. And my mom loved you. So thank you.
I know why I love Betty so much, because she, more than any mother woman I've met in my life, she reminds me so much of my mom. And those two are best friends in heaven right now. I know it. I just want to thank everybody so much who helped put together this beautiful liturgy. Kevin and Kathy and Jeannie, thank you for the beautiful music, and our staff who has helped put everything together, and our wonderful flower our ministers, Donna King and Julie Markalunas Hall, thank you for the beautiful decorations. And, thank you all. And my friends, this portion of the liturgy is what we call the final commendation. And let me offer this invitation to prayer. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Betty, and now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness and parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Betty again and enjoy her friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ. And now we will sing the song of farewell. My friends, immediately following this funeral mass, we will go to the Red Butte Cemetery for the committal of Betty's remains. And you are all welcome to join us there at the cemetery. It's a beautiful, beautiful ceremony, a continuation of this liturgy. Or you can remain here. The family has provided a delicious luncheon for everyone to join here afterwards. So you're welcome to come to the cemetery and come back and join us in the luncheon. We'll be outside in the courtyard, or you can stay here and wait till we come back. But please know that you're all welcome to celebrate Betty's life afterwards with all the stories that you know of her. And now I invite you to stand for the final prayer of commendation. Into your hands, Father, mercies, we commend our sister Betty in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Betty in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and a fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And now, in peace, let us take our beloved Betty to her place of rest.
Please join in singing our closing hymn, number 614, in the Green Journey Songs hymnal, How Great Thou Art.
How great thou art, how great thou art. And when I think that God his Son not sparing sent him to die, I scarce can take it in that on the cross my burden gladly bearing, he bled and died to take away my sin. Then sings my soul, my Savior.